Welcome to this .NET MAUI AI AssistView tutorial. Using the Syncfusion.NET MAUI AI AssistView, you can incorporate AI features into your .NET MAUI application, creating a user-friendly interface that facilitates smooth interaction with AI services. In this video, I'll show you how to add .NET MAUI AI AssistView control to the .NET MAUI application, make requests, and generate responses. Before you begin, ensure you have installed the latest version of Visual Studio 2022 with the required .NET MAUI workload. You should also have one of the .NET SDKs installed on your machine. After installing the necessary tools, launch Visual Studio 2022 and click Create a New Project on the dashboard. From the list of project templates, select the .NET MAUI application and provide the project name and location. I create the project with the .NET 8.0 framework. Now the default application is ready to use. Before moving forward, let me take a quick detour to set up the application's environment. I select the Android emulators from the list to view the output in the Pixel 5 emulator. Next, I'll run the application to show you the default output. The application compiles the default code in a few seconds. See, the application's home page is displayed. Next, to incorporate AI AssistView into the application, I need to install the Syncfusion MAUI AI AssistView NuGet package. So, I open the NuGet package manager and switch to the Browse tab. I search for the Syncfusion MAUI AI AssistView package, then select and install it in my project. After the package is installed, I need to register the handler for Syncfusion Core to map the cross-platform control API to the native view API. I open the MAUI program CS file and add the Syncfusion MAUI Core hosting namespace. Then register the handler by adding the configure Syncfusion Core method. Registering a trial license key is necessary to use the Syncfusion MAUI controls. So I open the apps.aml.cs file and add the register license method with the trial license key. To find out where to generate it, please refer to the instructions link in the description below. Next, I navigate to the main page XAML to initialize the control. I remove the default code from the content page section and import the Syncfusion MAUI AI AssistView namespace. Then I initialize the Syncfusion AI Assist view control. Once the application is loaded, you will see that the AI Assist view control is rendered. Next, let me show you how to request an item and generate a corresponding response. To do this, I navigate to the main page CS file. Here, I create a ViewModel class. Following that, I declare a public property of type iAssistItems. Within the constructor, create a new instance of observable collection and assign it to the items. To make item requests, I create a method generateAssistItems and call it in the constructor. In this method, I create an instance of the AssistItem class and set its dex property to listening. After that, I add the newly created request item to the items collection. Now I navigate to the main page XAML. Then set the view model as the binding context to the content page to bind and display data. Next, bind the items to the assist items property. You can see that the requested item is displayed. To display the item as a user request, I navigate to the generateAssistItems method and set the isRequested property to true. Now you'll see that the requested item is displayed on the right side, indicating that the user requested it. Let's see how to generate a response for the requested item. To do this, create a method called getResult, which will accept AssistItem as a parameter named requestItem. Within this method, create a delay of 5 seconds to pause the execution before generating a response. Then create a new instance of assist item and set the response item to its text property. After that, I set the isRequested property to false to present a text as a response from the AI service. Finally, I add the newly created response item to the items collection and call the method in the generateAssistItems method. When the application loads, the user request is displayed, and after a delay, the response appears. Next, I'll show you how to generate response from AI. Before proceeding, I'll remove the code snippets related to the previous responses. To process the user's request and generate a response, first, I create a class Azure AI Service, along with a constrictor. Then I declare a private array called PromptRequest, which will hold a list of predefined queries, and another private array PromptResponse, which will hold the responses that correspond to the keywords in the requests. Next, I create a method, getSolutionToPrompt, that takes a user's request as input and returns a response in the form of a string. I convert the input to lowercase to ensure that the comparison that is about to perform is case insensitive. After that, I create a loop that iterates through the prompt request array, which contains the predefined list of requests. Within the loop, I use an if statement to check if the lowercase prompt matches one of the items in the prompt request array. If a match is found, the method returns the corresponding response from the prompt response array. Each predefined request in prompt request has a related response in prompt response, so this line retrieves the correct response to display. If no match is found after checking all the predefined prompts, it returns a default message. Now I move to the view model. Here I declare a variable Azure AI of type Azure AI Service and initialize it in the constrictor. This variable will be responsible for processing prompts. Then I define a method called getResult to process the user's input query. Within this method, I simulate a delay for 2 seconds and cast the input query to assist item which contains both the request text and other associated data. Next, let me check if the request object is not null and call the getSolutionToPrompt method from Azure AI Service class, passing the text of the user's request. This call will return a response based on the predefined prompts. Then I create a new assist item to hold the response and add the response item to the items collection. To handle the user's requests, I create a method executeRequest command which is triggered when the user submits a request. Within this method, I declare a variable request to store the user's input and then call the getResult method with a delay, passing the request object. Finally, I define a command assistViewRequest command. Within the constrictor, assign the command to call the executeRequest command method, ensuring that the request is processed whenever the user invokes the command. Next, I navigate to the main page XAML. Here, I bind the assistViewRequest command to the request command property. Once that's done, I run the application. After the application is loaded, I create a request. And within a few seconds, the response is generated. Let's wrap up this video. You learned how to add the Syncfusion.NET MAUI AI AssistView control to your .NET MAUI application. You also learned how to create a user request and generate a response to it. If you want to see this example's work in code, download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also included a link to check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for all our .NET MAUI controls. If you found this video helpful, click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.